So today I'm going to be talking about and showing you guys what my process is for taking product photos for the shop. First of all, I shoot with a Canon 6D, mainly with product photography. I use the Canon 100mm L macro just because I like the compression of the images, and I'll be showing you the differences between 100mm and 50mm so you guys kind of understand what I'm doing with that. Today I will be shooting the Smok Stick AIOs. We just picked these up last night after the shop. We went to our wholesalers, hung out for a bit, bought some product, had dinner with our guys, and we walked back with some of these and some new Big Baby Beast tanks with new finishes. Like, this is a rainbow finish, gold, which I'm sure I already had, and then this new one, it's like a camo finish. So this is how I have the product set up. Personally, me, I like setting up the products in weird angles and making sure they don't really block each other from view. And I like to create depth in the image, whereas like this one's all the way forward, there's one in the back. So when I take the shot, there's depth. It doesn't look two-dimensional. And you guys will see that with the finished images. So first I'm going to shoot it with the 50mm lens. My current setting is at 1000 ISO at f9. The reason why I'm shooting f9 is because if I shoot faster than that, or wider, like 2.8, you know, 3.2, or like even 1.4, like that's, the depth of field is so shallow that only the face of the product would be in focus, and like immediately right after the product blurred out, and I don't want that. So f9 should give me a long enough depth of field to have a lot of the products in focus. So now I have my 100mm macro lens on. So in order for me to get essentially the same frame where the products are almost the same size, I would have to step two times further back than I did with the 50mm lens to get the same essentially frame. But the difference between a 100mm lens is the compression of the image. The background will look closer with the 100mm lens than it will with the 50mm. This is a comparison of the 50mm lens and the 100mm lens. This shot, this is the 100 and this is the 50. It's kind of hard to tell the difference between the two lenses, but when I show you the comparison, you'll be able to notice the difference. So here in this image, this is the 50mm lens. You can see the background, you see a lot more of the background, and it's pretty much the same frame, the same angle, very, very close. And you can see how the 100mm lens, the background is like, you can only see up to here, and it's like closer to you, versus this on the 50, you can see a lot more. So that's what I mean by the compression of the image that the lens produces. So the more zoomed in you are, let's say like a 200mm lens, this background is going to be a lot closer than your smaller focal length within the same magnification or framing. Here's another photo comparison with the 50 on this side and the 100mm lens on this side. In this angle, you could really see the difference between the two lenses, and it's the compression of the image it produces. Here the sign is a lot further back than here, so just be aware when you're shooting different focal lengths, try to understand how each lens compresses the image, and that comes with practice. The more you shoot, the more you try different lenses, you'll start to remember how these lenses affect their images. So just keep practicing, really. And then the more you do it, subconsciously you'll be able to just pick a lens depending on how you want your image to look. So here I'm going to show you my editing process, but first let me talk about the shot that I took and why I took it this way. I like shooting from a top down at an angle, just because I like seeing the foreground and the background as well. Like the plane of the ground acts as the background and the foreground, so you don't really see what's behind it, you only see what's pretty much beneath and behind the product. And it as it starts to blur out, it kind of gradates the blurriness, and that to me gives it a really appealing look. And here, these are all my custom presets that I've put together myself. I've put these presets together throughout my experience with photography and editing and processing in the past 2 years, and these are the presets I now currently have that I've created that I personally like. This is the one I use for the shop. It's called P.SBLCO++. Plus meaning the amount of fade I added to the image. Like this is at 10%, so per plus it's 5%. That's just how I do it. You could do it any way you like. Just a difference in tone curves alone, you can tell. But this photo, I'm going to try my preset that I've made more for like lifestyle and portrait photography. It's called MCG++. It's a little more duller, not as the highlights or the whites are more dumbed down or more flat. And you can see that in the images. So first let me find my crop. For Instagram, their biggest crop vertically is a 5.3. Actually, it's a 5.4. I'm sorry. So I look at my guides here. These are the lines that divide the frame in equal parts of threes, 3, 3, 3, and these are the points where you want to put your main subject or the focus of your subject. But rules were meant to be broken. You could frame it and crop it however you like. This is just how I like to do it. So for me, the button here on this gold one is a point for me, so I'm going to place that on my line here, and then this button is on my other line, and then the black, that was my main focus and when I focused for the image, so that's going to go right in the middle of the picture. And I remember when I was talking about depth, you see how the product goes this way, that way, and then that's behind that and that, so it kind of adds dimensions to the image so it's not so flat. So we start with my basic. Let me reset this here. So I'm gonna set my white balance to, let's try a different one, see which one I like. That's auto, so it's a little bit warmer. Daylight, since it's in broad daylight, it's really blue. Since we're in shade, we might want to try shade. So that's a little better. There's a lot of, what is this? Magenta in the image, so I might dumb it down a little bit. That. That looks a lot better already, and I haven't even touched my basics yet. Highlights, shadows, whites, and blacks. I have my clarity down because clarity pretty much sharpens the midtones. So I like it a little lower so it's not as crisp or as sharp. and then I have my saturation down so the colors aren't so, you know, too vibrant, as you can see. It's too low. It's too much in my opinion, but you know, you do it as you like. Whatever you feel looks good to you. So remember that photography is, it's subjective. Everybody has their own style, their own way of editing, their own look, and you create that style and your vision for the photo based from your experiences and what you've learned in processing, and then you just adjust it until you like what you see. You'll know what you like when you feel good about the image. I'm gonna mess with my highlights. If I bump the highlights up too much, you notice that you start to lose the detail in the highlight of this mod or this product. So I'm gonna bring it down, let it bring some detail back. Let's do the whites. So I'm gonna pump the whites up, just add a little bit of contrast. And then shadows and blacks, we'll just play with it. So me, as of right now, my style, I like my blacks to be a little further up on the slider, so it's a little brighter. And then shadows, I either pump up or go down depending on how I want the image to feel. So with this image, I feel like I want it to be a little more moody. So I'm gonna bring the shadows down. Something like that. So just based on this and my tone curves, you can see the difference. So that's pretty much it for my basic. And then I mess with split toning depending on the kind of tones I want in the picture. So I start with my highlights first. I have my preset in blue at 12% saturation. And then I'll look for colors that I feel fit the image. I want to go with like a bluish, light blue at 12% saturation. And shadows, we'll start with my blue at 12%, and then we'll move it around. I'm probably gonna go more on a little yellowish, a little bit of green in the shadows for my split toning. And then my balance, we'll figure out if I want more yellow in there, more blue. I'll probably go a little more on the blue side, make it a little cooler. So that's the difference in just split toning alone. It's a slight difference, but it's a noticeable difference. The end viewer, whoever looks at this finished product, they wouldn't know what to look at, what any of this stuff means, because they don't see the process. So the final image would essentially look like this, but I know that there's blue in the highlights, yellowish in the shadows, just to give it a little bit of tone, a little bit more mood in a sense. That's pretty much the image for that. So that's pretty much my process for taking pictures. And then, and I do that every day. You guys see it on Instagram, in my email posts, on my Facebook. And that's the process of my photography. A lot of people who don't understand photography tend to think that it's just simple, you just take a picture and call it a day, which it's really not. And that's why I'm doing this, just to kind of show you guys what it takes to create an image. And then if you're, you know, people who are really deep about photography, a lot more work goes into creating one image. Like, this is a simple process. This if I were to do this without recording anything in between, I could get my shots done in less than 10 or 15 minutes. But let's say if I was out doing more of a professional shoot for a client or something like that, from the photo shoot itself, it can take anywhere from a few, you know, an hour to a few hours to a whole day just for shooting. And then, you know, take it back home, throw it on a computer, upload it, edit it, process the images, sort them, upload them, you know, whatever, organize, whatever I need to do. That can take another couple hours, sometimes a couple days, just to finish the images as far as processing goes. So hopefully you guys understand a little bit more. And yeah, and plus this is my first video I created. I'm just kind of going off a tangent. I didn't really write a script or anything. I'm just going off the top of my head. And hopefully you guys learned a few things. And if you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you.